You know, you start to accuse your own government of murder, you start to sympathize with the enemy, Iran.
And when he took his goddamn war, he took her name.
The terrorists attacked us and killed 3,000 of our citizens.
Dick Cheney needed 9/11 to happen.
Why did building number 7 come down? And why did
it have a 50,000 gallon pump? And it got hit by the fucking planes.
It is impossible for a building to fall the way it fell without explosives being involved.
It just raises a lot of questions.
Now, is Charlie Sheen ranting like a lunatic about the September 11th attacks?
Her question raising, as she likes to posture it, is really just a slap in the face to every single victim of 9/11 and their families.
Okay, I'm probably the largest advocate for the 9/11 families. I run about 6 different support groups, okay, and I'm on the board of almost every family advocate group, and I reach 7,000 family victims.
With your 7,000 members, I'm sure you've talked to most, if not all of them. Mm-hmm. Run the gamut. What percentage, just guesstimation, would you say believe 9/11 is an inside job to some extent?
Probably 50-50.
I have my own syndicated show. I've done 4,000 radio interviews in the last 4.5 years. Almost no one calls in and disagrees now. We have the majority view.
Charlie Sheen speaks out. Do you agree with his assertion that there is a government cover-up of 9/11? Let's take a look at how the vote is going so far. 82% of you say yes, only 18% of you say no.
A quote from Time magazine. A Scripps Howard poll of 1,010 adults last month found that 36% of Americans consider it very likely or somewhat likely that government officials either allowed the attacks to be carried out or carried out the attacks themselves. 36% adds up to a lot of people. This is not a fringe phenomenon. It is a mainstream political reality. 108 million is more than 3 times the population of Canada. In 2006, a Zogby International scientific poll revealed that half of New Yorkers believe U.S. leaders had foreknowledge of impending 9/11 attacks and consciously failed to act. 49% of 300 million Americans is 147 million people. CBS asks the question, when it comes to prior knowledge of the 9/11 attacks, do you think members of the Bush administration are telling the truth, or are they hiding something, or are they mostly lying? Only 16% believe they are telling the truth. What you have seen are scientific polls. Now here are some non-scientific polls. Colbert Nation in June 2006 asks simply, was 9/11 an inside job? 66% said yes. AM 640 Radio Toronto asked the same question in August of 2006. Was 9/11 an inside job? 85% said yes. MSNBC asks the question, do you believe any of the conspiracy theories suggesting that the U.S. government was somehow involved in 9/11? This is the result. 63% is 189 million people. Are all these people crazy?
These are the worst, most fringe, kookiest, discredited academic crackpots who believe that the Secret Service and the CIA planted a controlled demolition of that building.
Scholars for 9/11 Truth has over 200 members. Most of these members are PhDs in physics, humanities, political science, history, computer science, engineering, etc. Scholars for 9/11 Truth and Justice has a similar member list of over 200 PhDs, researchers, and experts from a wide range of academic disciplines. More experts and other individuals who doubt the official 9/11 report can be found at Pilots for 9/11 Truth, Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth, 9/11truth.org, 9/11 Truth Europe, 9/11 UK, 9/11 Truth Seekers, New York 9/11 Truth, the 9/11 Coalition of Families, Washington DC 9/11 Truth, Boston 9/11 Truth, Vancouver 9/11 Truth Society, Infowars.com, and many other organizations worldwide. If you believe 9/11 was an inside job, you are not alone. No matter what mainstream media tries to tell you.